Okay, folks, it's reviewing time, and we're the Reviewing Geeks. And what is today's review gonna be about? Let's find out in a second. Yes, there's a clue. Okay, and it turns out. It turns out to be the Prince of Pain, the Shogun Prince of Pain, Garo himself from Mortal Kombat. Yeah, indeed. And this is a special version, edition, bloody version, which I'll be explaining in a sec. And, you know, the new Mortal Kombat movie is coming out, so I decided to do a few of my MK figures review. Downstairs on the bottom, you can see it's written Mortal Kombat Garo. You have the side, just a second. On one side, you have a picture of Garo himself. And on the other side, we have Garo in a pose, which is nice. It's written MK Garo. And then on the back, just I hope the video works out unlike last time. You have a bit of what's written about him. I don't know if it's clear. I'll try to zoom down. Okay, so there's the zooming down. And this tells you what we have. We get a fireball accessories. We get two interchangeable heads, which seems cool. And Garo knows Sub-Zero is not added in this thing, though it'd be nice if he was. And is there anything else? That's it. So now we'll be opening this thing for review. So let's find out how this figure turns out to be. I was impressed with the Last Storm collectible figure. I need to check the posing, but otherwise, just a minute. Okay, and seeing how I have to recheck the posing and all, but here it is, Garo himself. I removed him from the box. Yeah, as last time, it's nice they pack these things up well. And these plastic things for protection. Here you can see he's got these extra, wrists. So where are the wrists? Where's the camera? Hey, where's the camera? Sorry, I don't feel comfortable with this camera. Alright. So, you know, these are the camera. You can see nice details. Even the nails are painted. Yeah, one head, I guess. So here are the fireball. That's a dog. Here's the fireball special effect. You have the two of them, and yeah, as you can see, he's all bloody version because this is the bloody edition, which is about, I'd say, I think this was about $100. I got it off the guy gave it to me for a discount, so it was about $90 or something. Now I'll remove the figure itself. Okay, so here he is out of box. This pony, as you can see, comes separately. He comes with another one as well. Just let me get that in a sec. There you can see that's the other head with the other pony, which you can just, you know, insert it. There are these holes up there where you insert the, you know, thing. I don't know why they didn't come, you know, already a thing, kind of. As you can see, there's a nice gore and detail behind. There's also the, you know, tiger spots, some people like to call them. So there, this thing is, you know, nice kind of thing. It's, you know, sash. And, yeah, that's pretty much it, Garo. And let's check out the articulation now. I'll be heady, where'd he go? Oh, yeah, I think he'll go full 360. Nice head. Yeah, he won't get out. The pony, on the other hand, might get out, but you know, that's not really a big deal here, I'd say. Unlike the Chun-Li figure, he's kind of heavy, but you're gonna expect the head goes down. Yeah, goes up this much. Oh wait, it's not zoomed up properly, sadly. Yeah, I mean, yeah, pretty much, yeah, he doesn't. This seems, the chest piece here seems to be a separate kind of piece. So he's gonna allow you the ab crunches. You can see. Yeah, he's just looking up there. And wait, can you see the app wrenches properly? Yeah, I'm gonna be doing a few experiments later on with an thing. Yeah, and like the previous Storm Collectible, this also comes with a stand, though I wouldn't use it for opposing him because, you know, he's so bulky, I don't think it would even fit. But I'd expect to use it maybe for the fireball accessories. Let's see. And yeah, this guy's got like not one, two, but four freaking arms. So they each should have their own, you know, articulation. So let's check them out. The ones on the top, let's get this guy up straight. Go up this high. I think they can go, yeah, slightly higher. This one, as you can see, they stretch out, you know, this much. Bottom one, sure, yeah, they'll probably. I'll just put him on the ground for a better thing. His wrist, they go full, you know, they rotate. It goes, elbow goes this much. Ooh, I won't risk it. He goes this feeling far enough. His arm goes up all the way this much. Yeah, you know, winning pose. So this is Garo wins, you know. Yeah, see. You can see Garo wins. Yeah, he's looking weird without his pony. I'll get that up. Yeah. So here we go in a winning pose. And this one, you know, these parts rotate. So they rotate pretty well. Yeah, I think you got the hang of that. There's a nice pin job up there, I'd say. Right, so that's pretty much it. Alright, just let me put him again in the ground for better thingy machingy. Okay, as you can see, there's a chest, you know, gap like there, you know, allowing him. Hands have nice. I wish my Wolverine figure could have done that. So, yeah, another cool pose for him. There you go. And yeah, they rotate pretty much the same. So yeah, they're pretty much cool rotation in the arms. So yeah, that's a plus point. Now for the ankles. I had last time trouble with Chun-Li. But yeah, that's pretty much how much back it goes. The ankle. Unlike Chun-Li, he does not have the toe ones. Oh, and oh wow, look, he pretty much backs up that much the kick. So yeah, it's pretty good actually. So on his knees, Garo on his knees. Whoa, he knows yoga. Garo knows yoga. Let's check it out. I know yoga. Impressive, isn't it? Okay, and now for the leg, how high goes. So there you can see that high his leg goes up that high. That's nice. The legs, the knees, you know, can go this much. And let's see if he can do any splits. I mean, he's not a split guy, but let's check it out, you know, if he can do any splits. So yeah, he learned a few tricks from Johnny Cage himself, a split after his defeat. So yeah, there he goes, he got nice splits. And I want to check something else about Garo's ankles. Yeah, just let me check and give me a sec, please. Okay, so yeah, these ankle, he does have movement in these, you know, ankle. So yeah, it goes up, goes a bit, does go up slightly, but you don't really notice it that much. But yeah, as I said, it does have a bit of an ankle movement. So that's pretty much your Garo. Let's check out the fireball effects now, and I might try risking the wrist to just see if it works out, you know, how it all works out. Okay, so just a sec. So there you can see I've posed the fireball effect, though it's more like a flying fist, as you can see. I don't know why it's written a fireball effect. I mean, he does the fireball button games, but this really, really looks like a you know, energy fist, you know, kind of thing. I don't know, whatever it is. Okay, so that's pretty much a Garo kind of review. I'll try to put a pose, make him with a few poses now. Just check that out. First off, that's him in comparison with the Storm collectible Chun-Li. You know, since this is a joke, you can say, between, you know, the last time I commented someone and I posted the Chun-Li why she isn't. So here she is in Mortal Kombat, you know, there she is, you know. So let's check out a pose between these two. Okay, I hope you guys catching this bit. So yeah, this is what happens when Chun-Li watches too many Hollywood flicks with Johnny Cage in it. I try to replicate the scene, it doesn't really work out all that well, but you know, you get the idea. There he's. Poor Gaara's groaning in pain. Oh my poor little, you know. And then let's check it out, something else out. There, you know, just like in the game, he can, you know, hold a character in his arms and gets ready to pound them up. So yeah, that's Goro for you. Well, poor Chun-Li survived this. We'll have to find out, you know. Oh, yeah, I didn't get a spin kick for her, you know, so let's try that move for Chun-Li as well. There you go, Chun-Li trying to give him a spinning kick, you know. So yeah, but it said Garo's got the cool pose again. So yeah, there's another dynamic pose. I mean, he has a bit of variety. So yeah, I mean, I like Goro. He's not bad, I'd say. I don't know, I'll give him give him nice figure, you know, nice bulk and all. I'll give him probably another 8. I just don't get why they give you 2 fireball effects. I mean, and they give you 1 stat. I mean, it doesn't really make that much of a sense, all that sense to me. But hey, that's the review for Goro from Storm Collectibles. I hope you liked it. Yeah, he's got a bit, as you can see, his waist, torso can, you know, move a bit, but it's a bit stiff. I didn't think it worked. I mean, after a bit of testing, I noticed this. So yeah, how much? I'll have to do a few more. I'll have to do another testing review and give it to you. But overall, I'd say it's nice. I didn't think I'd get this guy in a pose like this. So you know, that's another nice thing for him. Anyway, that's it with the Reviewing Geeks. I hope you liked it and enjoyed this video. I'll try to make a few more as soon as I can. Till next time, Reviewing Geek out.